you. Up next, her young son died in a hot car. Her husband is facing murder charges. Leanna Harris remains under scrutiny, but is hoping to clear her name with a new polygraph test. The results, my exclusive interview with her attorney next. Welcome back. The Georgia man who's accused of killing his toddler by leaving him in a hot car this summer will be back in court this week. Justin Ross Harris is charged with 8 counts, including murder. His attorney says Harris left his son Cooper in the car by accident. Prosecutors say both Harris and Cooper's mother, Leanna Harris, had searched online for how hot a car has to be to kill a child. The mom is not charged with anything, but she took a polygraph anyway. It was not court sanctioned, and it was administered by a private company. But her attorney, Lawrence Zimmerman, says that she passed that polygraph. I spoke with him a short time ago in a 360 exclusive. First of all, how is your client holding up? I mean, it's one thing to lose a child and then to have this entire legal battle and her husband facing possibly the death penalty.
She is holding up as best as any human being can. She's strong, but she's very scared. She has lost a child. She's lost her husband. And she's waiting to see how this whole thing plays out, but it's very scary for her.
She still supports her husband, though. She believes he's innocent.
Yes, she believes it was an accident. Mm-hmm. There's no doubt in her mind.
No doubt at all?
No doubt at all.
Was there ever a moment of doubt for her, or from the moment this happened, has she been supportive of her husband?
She always thought it was an accident. Mm-hmm. She's never had a doubt. She never voiced a doubt to me.
And even when, you know, things came out in court about him and in his private life, she didn't waver?
No, she didn't waver because she always knew and she saw the relationship that he had with their child Cooper, and he was always a great dad. She never saw anything different.
Mm-hmm. So what happens now? I mean, is she able to see her husband?
She could go to the jail and she could see him, and she does when she's in town, and she could talk on the telephone, and those calls are monitored by the jail, so they can't have conversations that are personal as far as how you're doing, talk about emotions, and
because they know people are listening in.
Right, nothing nefarious, but right. They just can't talk about intimate details of their life.
And have you talked to her about the possibility of him facing the death penalty?
We've chatted about that. We spoke about it today because this week the district attorney's office is supposed to announce whether they're going to seek the death penalty. And, you know, she really is trying to take things one day at a time. It's hard for her to fathom because she believes it was an accident. She believes that deep down in her heart. Her friends and family believe that. She can't then put that together and think that they're then going to move for the death penalty for something that they all think was an accident.
Does she want to be in court? Does she want to kind of follow this day by day, this process in the courtroom?
Sure. She would like to be present whenever he's in court. And the district attorney's office has even sent her a letter, because she's considered a victim by the DA's office. They sent her a letter asking her whether she wants to be in court when he's arraigned, if he has hearings. They want to hear from her as to whether she's going to be there or not.
It's interesting that the state considers her a victim. Does she consider herself a victim?
She doesn't think she's a victim of a crime. She doesn't think that at all. She thinks she's a victim of a tragic consequence, tragic accident.
The victim of she's a mother who's lost her child.
A mother who lost her child.
Since you're representing her, were you concerned at all that she would be in some way accused?
You know, Anderson, I'm always concerned with any client being accused because you have the police investigating. There's all been all these crazy things in social media. Some media outlets, not you, have said some things that have been uncouth. And so, of course, I'm always concerned. I think at this point, I would be very shocked if they decided to now charge her since they've already indicted the husband.
You haven't gotten any indication that they were considering charges or that they would actually...
They haven't said one way or the other if she's even a suspect, a target, or if they're even ever planning on charging her.
So you did have her take a polygraph test.
I did.
That was something that you guys decided to do. It was privately administered by you. By your person?
Yes. Daniel Sosnowski, who's a very well-known, 30 years, he's been doing polygraphs.
Why did you want to have her do a polygraph? Because it's not admissible in court. It's not, you know, something you could use down the road.
If the district attorney's office ever came to me and wanted to know if she ever took one, or if it would maybe help as a negotiating tool if later on they were trying to press her and try to charge her.
What were the results of it?
According to Mr. Sosnowski, she passed the three relevant questions.
pertaining to potential involvement.
I think there are more along lines. Right. Did you know that your husband was planning on doing this? Were you ever aware? Did you have any involvements?
You deal with a lot of people facing very tough circumstances, facing the loss of their livelihood, facing the loss of their freedom. Overall, how do you think she's doing?
I think she's doing really well. I couldn't imagine being in her position. I'm not so sure I'd ever be as strong as her losing a child. I have a child too. I couldn't imagine. I look at her, she is a pillar of strength.
Thank you so much for being with us. I appreciate
it. Thank you.